Hello, welcome to If. We post a new video for you every week. Give that little red sub button a click and stay up to date. This week we ask the question, which species will inherit the Earth? We are going to imagine a world in which humanity has long since disappeared. What animals would most likely rise up to take our mantle? Which animal group has the brains or the ability to evolve into a civilized culture? Let's take a journey into the future and speculate on our planet's new masters. The first animal we will look at has just made the news with the discovery of an underwater city. This is where these animals cohabit and build simple structures, communicate, and have a simple aquatic community. What creature is this, you ask? Mermaids? Crabs? Nemo? Nope, it's the humble octopus. Scientists recently found that the spectacularly named gloomy octopus, or to use its correct name, octopus tetricus, are not the loners they were once considered to be. The Australian discovery found that the species has been seen to congregate. They communicate and have been living in a little aquatic city known as Atlantis. They have even been observed evicting one another from the site when they are a disturbance to their eight-legged neighbours. Jervis Bay, south of Sydney, is the location of this marine marvel. Professor David Shill led the research. He draws a direct comparison with our own communities. His new report states, these behaviours are the product of natural selection and may be remarkably similar to vertebrate complex social behaviour. Other Minds, a book by Peter Godfrey Smith, calls the octopus an intelligent alien. The scuba diving philosopher of science looks into the wonders of cephalopods and says they are smart and playful creatures who live outside the brain-body divide. These animals are said to possess the intelligence of a three-year-old human. This recent find confirms scientists' suspicions about cephalopods and culture. And this octo city is not the only one. Another site in Jervis Bay, found just 50 feet below surface, was discovered in 2009 and was given the name Octopolis. This artificial reef, an underwater island of safety in a dangerous area, a defense against predators such as sharks, seals, and dolphins. The octopi had constructed walls from their discarded clam and scallop shells. The report's co-author, Stephanie Chancellor, noted that these piles were sculpted into dens, making these octopuses true environmental engineers. Godfrey Smith concluded that these are multi-generational places that may concentrate the evolution of the octopus's brain. Let's take this already intelligent animal and give it a few thousand more generations of evolution. Dr. Russell Burke, a Hofstra University biology professor, specializes in ecology and evolution. He has a few predictions that will make your brain spin. He said, cephalopods have a lot of characteristics that we think of as being important to humans. First, they have relatively large brains in relation to their body size. So, large brains, like humans, check. They have big eyes, connected to that big brain, which means they work in the same kind of world that we do. He adds, their large eyes are very complex eyes, and they work much like ours. Cephalopods have perfect eyes for world domination. You make a big fuss about opposable thumbs. Imagine if we had eight of them. Tool building would be a very easy task. Cephalopods can clearly manipulate objects. They use tools. They don't build things aside from shelters, but it's certainly imaginable that given the time and given some other factors, those kind of things could happen. So at the time of writing this, he was unaware of the discovery of Atlantis. Could they be evolving quicker than we think? If a cephalopod learns something, tries some trick and it works, and another cephalopod sees it, they're definitely going to learn by watching each other. So if those patterns of behavior develop, it could pass among groups very quickly. Okay, so these octopi seem like a good option. They are what we imagine when we think about aliens that have tentacles, big eyes, and brains. Are they the next in line for world domination? Not so fast. There are a couple of other contenders. Sticking with the oceans, how about dolphins? Dolphins are already thought to be the second most intelligent species on the planet. A 2004 study led by Dr. Laurie Marino, neuroscientist and marine mammal expert, found that dolphins have encephalation levels. Encephalation being a rough estimate of intelligence that compares brain mass to an organ's total body mass. Theirs below only a modern humans and above all other mammals. Dolphins have brains that are about 4 times the size you would expect for their body size. They're pretty close to us. In comparison, a human has encephalation of approximately 7.5. What if dolphins are the species of super genius, just biding their time, waiting for us to step aside and hand them the planet? Well, maybe not, and here is why. Marino says, "I don't think they will take our place." The reason is dolphins have been successful as a very smart species, or rather, an order of mammals, for tens of millions of years. If we disappear, the only thing that really would happen is that they would be free to continue their lives. I don't think there would be any reason for them to become anything like us. It would honestly be a step down. In this study, it was found that dolphins developed their intelligence between 60 million and 20 million years ago. In other words, dolphins have had, at the very least, 20 million years to take over the planet, and either have had no reason to do it, or have chosen not to. Okay, so the oceans only give us one real contender, but what about dry land? Well, first I think we need to remove primates from our list. They did, after all, evolve into us, so let's call that a win and move on. Raccoons and bears may be a good group to take a look at. Marino says, sometimes you think raccoons are just going to take over the world. Those kinds of animals that have to deal with the same pressures as humans, especially in the urban environment. I think they are facing a lot of pressures to improve selection. The Scientific American blog writer Jason G. Goldman agrees with Moreno's sentiment. He says, "It's certainly possible that something like a rat or raccoon could eventually evolve human-level intelligence." Although Goldman also thinks other animals would do it before raccoons. What species could achieve human-like language, human-like teaching, and human-like tool use after a few million years of evolution? The candidate species might be chimpanzees or bonobos, or dolphins and whales, or elephants or ants. Each of these species is already part of the way there. For each of these elements, notice that each of the candidate species is social. I think this is key. Ashley Benison, an evolutionary and behavioral ecology postgrad student from the University of Exeter in Cornwall, England, thinks a little differently. She said, "Take humans out of the equation and we are left with a world that is changing at a much slower rate. In a much slower world, I'd expect the rise of the herbivores at first, only to be capitalized by the carnivores later on. Bears, cats, and dogs, already incredibly clever animals, could potentially become fantastically efficient predators, capitalizing on the much higher numbers of available prey. So what I'm hearing is that with more prey in a world without humans, large carnivores could have the chance to sit back, relax, and focus less on eating and more on developing societies. This could affect or lead to many clever animals starting to converge on our niche, if you will." Benson says, "So my vote? Probably the bears. Those guys are awesome." That's it, they were our contenders. Which group do you think is most likely to end up at the top of the food chain? Will Earth end up looking like an alien world filled by an octopus? 8-legged citizens slithering back and forth going about their day? Or will it be a planet of dolphins? A society lacking in construction? A civilization based on communication? Or the final world, something that resembles the Thundercats? Or a planet filled with rocket raccoons? Let me know which you think is most likely in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give us a like, or if you're an animal plotting world domination, a dislike. I will see you next time.